What's up, YouTube? This is Brian Pfeiffer, aka the Marketing Meathead, and today we're going to talk about bottle service in Las Vegas. All right, welcome back. Please read the disclaimer. I am not talking about anything financial here, just talking about having some fun in Las Vegas, buying some bottles, and making your vacation amazing. I'm Brian Pfeiffer. I'm the owner of a company called Surreal Nightlife and Bottle Service. Started back in 2002 in the nightlife business in Chicago. I actually started working the door at a nightclub and then threw a party at that nightclub. That turned into once a month, and then it was once a week, and then it was 4 days a week. Originally, the company was in Chicago. It was called SurrealChicago.com. Then Surreal turned into SurrealNightlife.com, and then we have since changed the name to Surreal Nightlife and Bottle Service. And it's funny that the bottle service thing has gotten so big in Las Vegas. There was a time when bottle service wasn't even that big of a deal. In fact, there was a number of years in there that I worked in the business that bottle service was technically illegal in the at least in the Illinois with the liquor laws and whatnot. And they found a way to kind of get around that, and then ultimately they made it legal. And now it's become definitely a big thing. In Las Vegas, they pretty much design the clubs these days to be conducive to the customers that want to buy bottles. The layout is typically the DJ kind of in the center of attention, and then the layout is all around, and then there's a dance floor, but the layout with all around with the seating is all for bottle service. And most of the clubs, if you don't have a table, the experience is, you know, less desirable. The dance floors are usually pretty crowded, and then there's walkways that are very crowded and uncomfortable. If you don't have a place to kind of hang out, you're just getting pushed around, and it's not a very good experience. So if you're coming to Vegas with a big group, especially a group of, say, more than five people or seven people or eight people, you might want to consider getting a table. And in order to get a table, you have to buy bottles, and that's how bottle service was kind of conceived. If you have such a big group, some of these girls, they come to Vegas with groups of 10 women, and ultimately that's going to overload a table with too many people, and they're not going to want to have that many girls at a table, because the cost of like one drink, roughly, when you work out the math, is somewhere in the neighborhood of around $50 for bottle service. So a lot of times guys, they want to bring some girls to the table, but they don't want to necessarily bring a group of 10 girls to the table, because it just overwhelms the table in many cases. So even women, I saw a lot of bottle service too, because they want to have a place to hang out. They get their feet start hurting and whatnot because of the high heels and whatnot, and it's nice to be able to sit down and kind of enjoy the night on a special occasion like a bachelorette party or a birthday party or whatever. So we have a lot of male bottle service customers, of course, and then a lot of female bottle service customers as well. So a little bit about me is I've been in the business out here in Vegas for about 6 years now. I'm going on my 6th year. I was moved out here originally by the Hakkasan Group to help open Hakkasan. I was part of the opening team. I was the promotion manager for Hakkasan and Wet Republic in 2013 into 2014. And had a nice run over there. Realized pretty early on that I had a lot of customers from my many years of business in Chicago and my relationships from those customers to other cities and whatnot. And I was getting, a ton of bottle service business, and it just made more sense for me to be an independent host promoter and bring in, my customers to all the venues in Las Vegas instead of just a couple. Grew the company really well out here. Have since bought a couple other companies. Now I have a bachelor company and a bachelorette company as well, and I have this Surreal Nightlife and Bottle Service and a VIP hosting company, and we do everything. We do packages, we do activities, we do strip clubs, nightclubs, pools. We even book some hotel rooms, discounted suites, etc., like things like that. So if you're looking for any of that, feel free to stick around to the end of the video. I'll make an offer to you guys. But let's get started today on bottle service in Las Vegas and give you kind of the ins and outs of how it works and what you need to know. You came here today because you want to know you know, who I am, and then, you know, you want to know about bottle service in Las Vegas. And, you know, basically bottle service is you're buying bottles at a premium price to, you know, get real estate in a nightclub, like a section in a nightclub where you can sit and have your own area and party with your friends and whatnot. Okay. And generally when you buy bottle service, you have to have some kind of a minimum spend on alcohol. And then you also get, you know, entry quickly, VIP entry, and you get, you know, a number of people in for free, you know, based on what your, you know, your minimum is and all that stuff. Generally, there's kind of like some rules of thumb, like, you know, for every $500 worth of minimum, you can get four people in. Those are kind of some general rules and whatnot. So, who am I? Again, I'm a business owner out here in Las Vegas. I've been doing this for 16 years. You can see here I have a Nevada gaming license. I actually had to take a hair test and pass like a 10-year background check with the FBI and whatnot. And I also have a Clark County, which is the Clark County is, you know, Las Vegas County. And I have a professional promoter license, which you have to have to be able to promote these nightclubs and whatnot. So it's pretty serious business out here. They're trying to, you know, really clean up the nightclubs as far as like the drugs and, you know, the bad people stealing people's money and whatnot. And you can always go to the Nevada gaming website and you can actually look at the licensed independent hosts. They have a section in there. I can put a link for that in below, and you can actually click on that link and see that, you know, all the different companies that are actually registered with the Nevada Gaming Commission that are allowed to sell bottle service legally in Las Vegas to people and packages and whatnot. Okay, so you know, before you get started with anybody, whether it's me or somebody else, make sure that they're a licensed independent host, okay? Or if they work directly for the nightclub, if they're one of the internal hosts, then they've had to pass some kind of a background check as well. Every person that works in the nightclub has to have a clean record. You know, I think it goes back like 10 years and even further in some cases. And you have to have a Nevada gaming license in order to work in a nightclub as an independent host or an internal host, okay? So let's clarify that. Even the security guys nowadays at the nightclubs and the bottle service girls have to be registered with the Nevada Gaming Commission. Anybody that works in the nightclub has to have the licensing. Okay, so understand that. As far as Las Vegas goes, there's over like 10 million people that visit the nightclubs a year, and there's over 50 nightclubs and lounges, and of course then there's the pool parties in the summer and whatnot. This video is going to be more focused on the nightclubs. I'll do another video down the road for the 2018 pool season when we figure out which pools are going to be open and which ones are not, some of the new floor plans and whatnot at some of the pools. But right now we're going to focus in on the nightclubs. This is 2018 and we're in the going into the fall season of 2018. So when I talk about these nightclubs, I'm going to go down the list of the A-list venues, the ones with the bigger DJs, and then kind of the B-list venues. And I'm going to kind of go the ins and outs of all those venues. And as I go through each venue, I'll flash the tip and tax percentage. I went ahead and got every tip and tax down to the exact amount, so you know what you're going to get added to your bill at the end of the purchase. Okay, so it's important to know this stuff because you don't want any surprises. You know, you might be collecting money from your group of, like, say, you know, eight or nine girls, and you know the girls have a tight budget, and that, you know, the person that puts a credit card down gets this huge bill at the end of the deal. So, and I'll explain some of the deals that I have at some of these venues as well, so you guys can really understand exactly how bottle service works in Las Vegas. Some of the A-list venues obviously are going to be more expensive, higher priced bottles, minimum spends, where some of the B-list venues still offer a very nice environment and a good party and a nice section. And you know, I can do deals where I have like an all-in price that's a lot less than, you know, some of the bigger clubs. So let's start going down the list of the different venues, and I'm going to start with the A-list venues and kind of give you guys an idea of, you know, each venue, and you know, you can make your decisions based on, you know, the kind of music you like and whatnot. You know, certain DJs are resident DJs at certain venues, but every year around the first of the year, they kind of switch places. So the venues that have the DJs this year may not have them next year. Depends. A lot of these guys sign like 2 and 3 year deals. Some of them are around for a while, some of them are not. You see the DJs swap around every year. Usually around to the first of the year, they, you know, they switch venues. That's typically when the contracts end and whatnot. So let's talk about the A-list venues. Of course, you got Omnia. If you haven't heard of Omnia, it's in the Caesars Palace. Bottle prices generally start around 600 to 650. They used to all be around 600. They've kind of raised the prices this year. And, you know, I'll flash the tip and tax below for each venue. I'm not going to keep mentioning it, but you'll see it pop up here as we go. So you'll know what the tip and tax is. The way it works is generally a minimum spend. You know, on a big night like Calvin Harris, there's going to be a minimum spend of probably $1,500 to get onto the terrace. And then there's a hip hop room, same thing, around $1,500 minimum. And generally, you're going to have to, you know, tip a little bit to get one of the better tables at the terrace or the in the heart room. And then that goes to the podium. That's called a handshake. And then there's the tip and tax, which is on top of the minimum. Okay. So, for example, you have a $1,500 minimum spend. Your tip and tax is roughly 35%. And you're going to maybe have to tip like $200-$300 to the podium to get a decent table on one of those bigger DJ nights like a Calvin Harris Friday. Okay. That's going to be about $2,200 to $2,300 out the door. Okay, and you can get two bottles with that, okay, because bottles are $650 a piece, so you're $1,300 for the two bottles, so that covers $1,300 of your $1,500 minimum, and then you have another $200 left to spend on, you know, Red Bulls, water, shots, whatever you want to max out your minimum, okay? So that's how that works. Now, the resident DJs at like an Omnia this year, they got Cascade, Steve Angelo, Zed, you know, obviously Calvin Harris is one of their big ones, Steve Aoki is another one. They have a decent lineup. You can always go to surrealnightlife.com and check the lineups for all the nightclubs on the weekend that you're coming. Obviously, you don't really care what's going on this weekend or next weekend. If you're not coming until, you know, December, go in and look at, you know, maybe about 2-3 months out, you'll be able to see the DJs that are playing at each nightclub in December on the weekend you're coming. You can just sort by date on the website and it'll show all the DJs on there. So, all right, so that's Omnia. You got the main room, which is where the big DJs play. You got the hip-hop room, where the hip-hop music is, called the Heart of Omnia. And then you got the terrace, which is outside. In the winter months, if it's really cold, they'll close the terrace, or if it's a slower night, the terrace won't be open. It can get kind of hot up there in the summer. In the winter, they have heaters up there in case it gets a little cool. But generally, all three areas of the club are open on any given night. The nights that they're open, Tuesday nights is kind of their big industry night. They are open on the terrace or the heart room Thursday, depending on the time of year. Friday and Saturday are obviously open in the entire club. And then they do like a Sunday night, either terrace or heart party. Depending on the time of the year. In the wintertime, it'd be in the heart room, and in the summertime, it'll be in the on the terrace, okay? So that's Omnia. Next big player is Excess. Excess Nightclub's been around for a while, but it's still definitely one of the top-tier clubs. Big DJs like the Chainsmokers are there. They have Marshmello's a big name they got. David Guetta is a big name they have. Let me try to think who else they have. Major Lazer plays there once in a while. Again, like I said, go look at the website on the weekend you're coming. They'll show the DJs that are playing there that weekend. That's really all that matters to you. Bottle prices, okay? Excess is a little bit more expensive than the rest of the venues. Generally, their bottles start at like $6.25 for Absolutely Licks, and then it goes up to around $6.95 for Grey Goose. So, for example, if you have a $1,500 minimum table, you can only get two Grey Goose, and you have about $100 left to spend, because it's $700, $700, and then $100 left to spend. Okay, tip and tax will flash up below. Generally, they pretty much stay around those same prices. Occasionally, on a big fight weekend, and like a Memorial Day or a Labor Day, they'll come out with what's called a holiday menu and tack on about $100 a bottle or $50 a bottle. But I don't know if they're going to do that anymore or not. I haven't seen it the last 6 months or so. But sometimes be aware there's a holiday menu that comes out on a bigger weekend, and they get you for a little bit more on the bottle prices. So be aware of that. That's Excess Nightclub. They do have an indoor section, which is like a big horseshoe, and then they do have a nice outdoor pool area, which is very nice and chill. You can talk to people out there, and it's a real nice party out there as well. Then there's Hakkasan Nightclub. There's another one of the top tier A-list venues. A lot of the same DJs as Omnia. It's owned by the same, operated by the same group. Hakkasan Group operates Omnia and Hakkasan, so pretty much the same DJs. Hakkasan is the same bottle prices as Omnia, around $650 a bottle, $600 to $650 a bottle. Generally, minimums start around, you know, $1,000 at Hakkasan, and they go up to, you know, anywhere from $5,000 to $7,000, depending on who's there for the dance floor tables. $4,000 to $7,000 usually. Hakkasan's definitely not quite as hot as it was, say, you know, 2 years ago. It's now a five-year-old venue. They can get some pretty good deals there. I have, obviously, a very long-standing relationship with them. I helped open the place, and I have a lot of friends that still work there and whatnot. So Be happy to help you guys out with Hakkasan. The next top tier club is probably Dre's, I would say. Dre's has gone more of the hip hop route. They bring in guys like Trey Songz, Chris Brown. They have Migos there. They have a lot of the big hip hop artists, and it's definitely gone more down the hip hop route, but it's a big enough venue where they can afford to pay these big artists, and they can, you know, make the sort of like concert environments happen in there. And it is definitely a good hip hop party in there. They are open on Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday night, and Sunday's a hip hop night. Thursday's like usually DJ Esco, kind of a more general population night, and then the big artists Friday and Saturday. Dre's bottles are $600 a piece for Grey Goose, roughly. The tip and tax is 33.1%. Generally, it's about $800 a bottle with tip and tax, and you can usually get tables starting around $1,000 for the mezzanine or you know, a smaller banquette, depending on who the artist is, all the way up to, you know, $6,000-$7,000. So Dre's is a pretty hot club, definitely a good hip-hop party in there. If you're into the hip-hop music, it's definitely one of the hotter clubs. Next top tier club is Marquee. Now Marquee used to be one of the big dogs, you know, kind of Marquee in excess before Omnia came along and Hakkasan and Dre's. It's still a top tier club. They are booking some big artists. Lately they've been kind of going the hip hop route with like the Travis Scotts, the French Montanas, and the, you know, some of the other hip hop artists. They still do bring in like the Dash Berlins. I think he had to change his name recently, but they have, you know, Tritonal and a couple other EDM artists. So you got to really check the weekend when you're coming to see who's there. One night might be EDM, one might be hip hop. It's a little bit older club. The tables are kind of small compared to some of the newer venues, but it's still cracking. Definitely still a top tier club. You're going to pretty much pay full prices there. Bottles are expensive at Marquee. You're looking at about $650 to $700 a bottle. They have all kinds of tip and tax on there, and usually one bottle ends up being about $1,050 with a 34.25% tax and grat. So be aware of that. They do have some deals on Monday nights, and occasionally on like a winter, you know, Friday or Saturday, I can pull some deals off. So check with me on that. The final top tier club now is probably Jewel. Okay, Jewel was built recently in the last year, year and a half. It's in the Aria. It's a nice club, smaller than, you know, the big brother of Hakkasan and Omnia, run by the same group. They do have some of the same DJs, like Stevie Aoki plays there, Cascade occasionally. They usually have smaller talent in there. Real nice venue. Generally, tables are anywhere from around 1K minimum up to around 4 to 5K minimum for dance floors, depending on who's there. Sometimes a little more if it's a big artist, like sometimes on a Little John night on a fight weekend, it'll be a little bit more or something like that. But Jewel's a real nice venue. Bottle prices are the same as Hakkasan and Omnia, around $600 to $650 plus tip and tax. Nice venue, real nice lighting system, nice tables, big tables and stuff. So I would still consider Jewel one of the more A-list venues. So those are your A-list venues, okay? Now there's another level of venues that are usually, in some cases, either smaller, older, you know, maybe not in the best casinos, whatever. But we call them like the B-list venues. You can call them whatever you want. But generally at the lower tier venues, you can get better deals. You can get nicer tables for less money. You're not going to get the big artists like the Calvin Harris or the Chainsmokers at these venues. You're going to get probably like a scam artist DJ. Occasionally, they'll have a little bit bigger name at some of these venues. But more than often than not, it's a smaller DJ name, but they're still good parties, okay? The thing about Las Vegas is you need to understand that the people that come here come from all over the world, okay? UK, Australia, Montana, Mexico, Brazil. I have customers everywhere, international, okay? Most of these people don't really care about the big name DJs. Now, some of them do, and they're gonna pay to go see Calvin Harris or the Chainsmokers or whatever, but the rest of the DJs, most people just don't care. They just wanna go where it's a lot of fun, there's good looking people, and they can have a good time and get their, you know, get their alcohol buzz going, okay? So these places, I sell a ton of tables at every one of these venues, and 99.9% of the time, I get rave reviews. They had a great time. You know, these venues do a good job of filling them with people. You know, some of these B-list venues offer like open bar for the girls in the beginning of the night on the guest list to get the girls in there and fill them up. And sometimes in a lot of cases, these venues are more girls than they are in the big venues where it's a lot of money to get in and stuff, okay? So let's go down the list of venues here. We'll kind of talk about each one quickly, so you guys have an idea how the bottle service works at all of them. We have Apex Social Club. This was formerly Ghost Bar in the Palms, and they redid it, made it real nice. They're kind of bringing in, you know, girls from LA every weekend, and they're keeping it real upscale. is a nice high-end club. The bottles are anywhere from like 500 to 600 range, and you can generally get a pretty nice table for around 1,000 minimum. Sometimes I can work some deals depending on who's DJing and whatnot. So that's Apex Social Club at the Palms, okay? It's a nice venue. They're going to be doing a huge renovation of the Palms here. It's kind of under the way, and they're going to be opening up a huge pool and a huge nightclub there in the old Rain and Palms pool space. And, you know, Apex is going to be kind of like the, you know, the A-list crowd place in the Palms, even when that opens up. Okay, so that's Apex. The next club we can talk about is One Oak in the Mirage. If you've been to New York or you've been to LA, you know there's a One Oak in those cities, and we do have a One Oak in Las Vegas. It's not quite as prestigious as the one in New York or the one in LA. It's in the Mirage, and it's kind of a B-list club. It's, for lack of a better word, it's a little tired, but it's still packed on Friday nights as their bigger night. Saturdays are decent. They have a Wednesday night party as well. And you can get pretty good deals there. Hit me up. I got some specials there always. Generally, they don't have big artists. Occasionally, they'll book a bigger artist in there on like a Friday or Saturday, like a 2 Chainz or Brody Jenner sometimes as a host, or one of the Kardashians. Scott Disick's been there recently. And sometimes they kind of play off that little celebrity thing that One Oak is. You know, the night ended at One Oak in, you know, L.A. and New York and Las Vegas. So One Oak's a nice little, you know, nice little gem on Friday nights sometimes. Saturdays are pretty good too sometimes, and even Wednesdays are popping sometimes. Okay, so One Oak in the Mirage, there's some big tables in there. You can usually get a pretty nice table for a very reasonable price. If that's your scene, One Oak's a good place for you. Okay, the next venue I want to talk about is Chateau. That's in the Paris Hotel in Chateau. It's kind of an outdoor venue. In the summer, it's kind of hot up there, but very good bottle prices there. I don't really have much to say. They're pretty much the stuff on our website and their website's the same. They have good deals. Okay, you can get a couple bottles for around $600, $650 with tip and tax. You can get, you know, 5, 6, 7 people in with that, and get a decent table. You know, it's kind of your budget bottle service place in Las Vegas, and be happy to set you guys up there if you want to check out Chateau and you're on a budget. It's not bad. It's a little hot in the summer, maybe a little cold in the winter. They do have an indoor section if it does rain, or if it's really too cold or really too hot, I guess they could, you know, have the party inside. Generally, it's pretty packed on Wednesdays, Fridays, and Saturdays. If you have any questions about Chateau, just let me know. Then you got the Foundation Room. This place has been hanging around forever. I think this place has been around since I've been going out in the early 2000s, and it's still there. It's at the top of the Mandalay Bay, and the Foundation Room actually still packs them in pretty good. It's not bad in there. It's got kind of a, you know, that VIP type of feel to it. They have like a lounge setting earlier in the night with some food and appetizers and whatnot. I got some good deals on bottle service in there. I don't book a ton of stuff at the Foundation Room. It is kind of an older club, but I do occasionally get some requests for it. And again, they do have some bottle service specials and some decent tables in there. So hit us up if you're interested in the Foundation Room. Okay. There's Hyde Nightclub at the Bellagio. Okay. Hyde Nightclub is a very nice small nightclub. Okay. It's got a good vibe in there. They usually have a lot of confetti blowing off and a real lot of energy in there. The room's nice. They play a mix of, you know, hip hop, EDM, and it's kind of a little bit of 80s and 90s. I call it like a more mature crowd. If I have a group of, say, 35-year-old pluses, and they're like, I don't want to hang out with a bunch of kids, I'll send them to Hyde, and they always have a great time, okay? But is it all older people? No, it's a mix of 21 to 55, okay? But it's a great view, overlooks the whole strip in the Bellagio Fountains. It's a smaller club, but it gets packed, and it's fun, okay? Hyde is a great place if you want to get a good deal on a table and have a good party and just enjoy your night. Hyde's a great opportunity to do that, okay? You got Intrigue at the Wynn. Now, one could argue the Intrigue's more on the A-list level because it's a newer club, but, you know, kind of picked up where Trist left off. Trist was the old Intrigue, and now they redid it, and it's called Intrigue. It's kind of a the smaller brother to Excess over at the Wynn. You know, they do occasionally bring in the Chainsmokers or Afrojack into there, but generally, most of the time, it's your DJs like Flostradamus and, you know, who they got in there, Slander. They got some other more like trappy type of guys. Dylan Francis is another one that plays there. And it's usually pretty good. They generally are pretty smart. They get the girls in there with the free drinks early. And so the guys buy the tables and there's tons of girls around. The free drinks end and then they got to go somewhere. So it's a perfect spot for guys to meet girls. The club's real nice. They did a real nice redesign of it. They added some nice lighting and stuff. And they made it real nice. I like Intrigue. I think it's a great club. It is definitely not an A-list venue as far as I'm concerned, because they do, you know, they just don't have the big talent and they don't have the demand like the Excess does. But you know, they've got some great bottle service specials there. Tables are nice and big and roomy and new, and it's a nice club. Okay, it's a nice place to go if you're on a budget. You want to get that like newer club experience, but don't want to spend the money to go to one of the A-list venues. Intrigue's probably going to be for you. Okay, bottle prices generally anywhere from, you know, 500 to 600 range at Intrigue. All right, next club on the list is Light Nightclub, and this is at the Mandalay Bay. Light's been around for about 5 years. It is a bigger club, and it's definitely one of the clubs that I would recommend if you're on a budget but you want to get that big club experience in Las Vegas. We have some great bottle service deals at Light. The tables are big, they're roomy, they're comfortable, usually no headaches getting in and out of there. They got a huge dance floor. They do have some pretty good DJs like Metro Boomin. They bring in some other guys like Clinton Sparks once in a while. You know, a lot of like the scam artist type of DJs. My buddy Tony Arzanon from Chicago has played there a number of times, and they always got pretty good music. They play a little bit more hip-hop now than they used to, but they still mix in a little bit of EDM. It's a nice vibe in there. Tables are big, comfortable. There's usually a nice crowd in there. If you want to go get that big club experience on a budget, Light is probably the place for you in Las Vegas. And they are good on Wednesdays, Fridays, and Saturdays. And on the Memorial Day and Labor Day weekend, I think they open up on Sundays as well. They used to throw in after hours in there on those weekends, but they stopped doing that. It kind of sucks because those were a lot of fun. Encore Beach at Night. This was formerly like the Surrender Nightclub. They don't really have Surrender anymore. It kind of doesn't exist. They don't really do anything in the winter months. They only have this open at night on Thursdays, Fridays, and Saturdays, and Sundays on the holiday weekends, Memorial Day, Labor Day. But Thursdays, Fridays, Saturdays, Encore Beach at Night, they do like a night swim party. Okay, it's pretty cool. If you want to wear your tank top, you want to go in your swim shorts and your flip-flops, and you want to possibly get in the pool at nighttime, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Encore Beach at Night. They got some great bottle service specials. They pretty much treat it like a pool at night, okay? I can do some great deals there, get you a nice table close to the DJ or in the pool, and you can have a lot of fun and get, you know, splash some water and hang out with the people that are also in the pool, and it can be a lot of fun. So is it a little bit more down and dirty than your nightclubs? Yeah, because people aren't really dressed up. It gets a little bit, I guess, for the lack of a better word, a little bit ratchet in there, but it's still a fun party. So you got Encore Beach at Night if you want to get a little ratchet. I think that's the spot for you guys, okay? All right, so next on the list is Tao. Here's a club that's been around kind of near and dear to my heart for about 8 years, maybe longer, maybe nine. Used to do the Memorial Day and Labor Day with Eric Murillo at Tao. Used to keep it open to like 11 a.m. It was a pretty dang good party. But now Tao is kind of past its prime. It's definitely a little bit older club. They bring in DJ like DJ 5. They bring in some of the scam artist DJs. I can't think of the guys all off the top of my head. But DJ 5 was just there last week. We had the table right next to him, one of my customers. And I got some good bottle deals there. The tables are pretty good. They've remodeled the place a couple times, moved the DJ booth around, and now it's a little bit better. The tables are pretty roomy. They got a pretty decent sized dance floor. And if you want to go and have a good party and listen to some open format music, a little bit of house and a little bit of hip hop, get a good deal on a table and a bottle, Tao could be your spot. It's in the Venetian. It's definitely something you might want to consider. And finally, the last nightclub in the B-level list that I want to go over is Voodoo. Voodoo is at the top of the Rio, and it's a rooftop club similar to the Apex, and they got some great bottle deals. It's been around forever. It gets pretty packed after the Chippendales lets out at the Rio when all the girls come over there and get in for free. So there's, you know, a lot of women there. If you're a guy looking for women, that's kind of the after party for the Chippendales. And they got some great bottle service deals. It's roomy. There's a lot of, you know, tables there and a lot of big tables and whatnot, so it can be comfortable for a larger group. So if you're interested in a nice view, good deal, a lot of ladies after Chippendales, the Voodoo could be your spot. It's open, I believe, 7 nights a week. So definitely an opportunity there. Other than that, a couple other things I want to touch on is there's a couple off-strip places. I do a little bit of work with Blue Martini at Town Square. That's a bar, club place in Town Square, which is not far from the Strip. There's Embassy Nightclub, which is like a Latin bar if you're interested in that scene, salsa dancing and whatnot. And then you obviously got Fremont Street, which is a whole other scene of bars. And, you know, I don't really think they have too many clubs, but there is another option to go to Fremont Street if you're not interested in one of the nightclubs. And then the after-hours scene, which was, you know, kicks off around 3 or 4 in the morning, goes till maybe like 7 or 8 in the morning. You got Dre's After Hours, which is half hip hop, half EDM these days, more like tech house at Dre's. And then you got the Hustler Terrace, which is all tech house. The Hustler is a strip club, and they have like a rooftop terrace, and the sun comes up and it's outside and it's pretty nice. They play really good music. My buddy Brett Rubin's one of the resident DJs and kind of the organizer. He's got a pretty good ear for music and brings in some good DJs from all over the world, and they play some tech house at the Hustler Terrace. So if you want to stay up late and hear some good music, like tech house, if you're into that scene, that's a fun little place. And then again, Dre's After Hours for the half hip hop and half tech house after hours. So other than that, I mean, that's pretty much it. I mean, when you get a bottle service, you know, you get the VIP entry, you get the, you know, you get the free entry for the people and you get walked right in. You still have to pass through security and ID. People always ask, oh, do I have to wait in line? Well, yeah, you have to pass through, you know, security. They check your pockets and usually check for any kind of weapons. And some places even have metal detectors and whatnot. And they wand you, and Marquee and Tao now have ones that you walk through like the airport. And, you know, they're trying to keep everybody safe. It's, you know, it's a hodgepodge of people from all over the country and all over the world. And, you know, you get a lot of personalities in here, and they don't want any weapons and put the security staff or any of these people, patrons and whatnot, in at risk. So the last thing I really wanted to cover is kind of like the VIP host, a guy like me who's an independent host who works at all the nightclubs versus like an internal host, because I get this question quite a bit, like, you know, what's the advantage of working with you over an internal host? Well, there's a number of different advantages. Okay, first off, when you work with a guy like me, I work for you. Okay, I don't work for a nightclub, I don't work for, you know, Tao, I don't work for Hakkasan. Okay, I work for you. You book with me. My job and my goal for the weekend working with you is to make sure you and your group have an amazing weekend. Okay, because, you know, if I give you guys an amazing weekend, there's a pretty good chance you're gonna, you know, come back to me, number one, and book with me again, or send me a referral. I built my entire business off referrals and repeat customers. So, you know, keep that in mind. Also keep in mind that when you work with a guy like me, I'm licensed to work at every club. So, you know, generally when clubs are not sold out, which is a lot of times the case, especially in, you know, the slower times of the year, they're hitting guys like us up to bring business, and they'll give us incredible deals that, you know, not even the internal hosts have. Okay, so we get these awesome deals sometimes that internal hosts don't even get, and we can fill the club for them with, you know, our customers and whatnot. Okay, we also have a lot of buying power. Okay, if you think about this, we probably do 30 to 40 tables a weekend. Okay, over the course of a year, I do anywhere from $5 to $7 million in tables. Okay, $5 to $7 million. You're buying one table for say $5,000. Okay, you think you're a big spender. I spend $5 million, maybe $7 million. Okay, do you think the guy like me coming in with my customer is going to have a better chance of getting, you know, the best table, or a guy that's spending $5,000? Okay, I think you know the answer to that question. Obviously, the guy that's spending $5 to $7 million gets his pick of the tables and works with the top people at all the nightclubs and managers and whatnot, and we pretty much can pick our tables, and when I can guarantee you something, I'll get what I guarantee you. I mean, that's just how it works. Okay, we've been doing this for a long time. You can look at my reviews. I'll flash them up on the screen here. Here's 125 stars. Here's 105 stars on another one of my Yelps. I have multiple Yelps, multiple Google reviews, multiple Facebook pages. All 5-star reviews. Okay, I think I've had like one-star review, and it wasn't even like a customer of ours that called the wrong. They accused our company of something, and it wasn't even our company. So that's just how it goes. So, you know, if you work with an internal host, I mean, don't get me wrong, I have a lot of internal hosts that are friends of mine. I'm not ragging on them, but, you know, they're working for the venue. They're trying to hit numbers. Generally, most of the time, they probably won't even be walking you in. They may or may not come up and say hi to you. You know, our focus is you for the weekend. We want to, you know, go up to the table with you. We want to make sure you're happy with your table. If you're not happy, we're going to make adjustments, and we're going to make you happy. Okay, that's just how it works. Sometimes things don't always work out exactly as planned, and if the table that you received is not exactly what you wanted, we'll do what we can to make it the table that you want. Okay, so, you know, keep that in mind when you're working with you know an independent host versus an independent host. So now that we've kind of come to the end of the video, you know, this is the time where I kind of want to make an offer to you guys. You know, we are more than happy to answer any questions that you want to have. Go ahead and, you know, click on the link below and fill out a form. Let us know when you're coming. We like to know how many guys and ladies are in your party. You know, if there's any special requests, if you really want to see, you know, Calvin Harris or Chainsmokers, go ahead and leave that in the comments, and we'll go ahead and you know, get you on the phone and go over your Vegas vacation with you. I have a team of salespeople that work for me, and we'll answer any questions that you may have, and we'll do our best to work within, you know, your budget. We have packages with limos and dinners and show tickets. We do all the male Revues for the ladies out there, Magic Mike, Chippendales, you name it. Aussie Heat, Thunder Down Under. We do all this. We rent exotic cars. We rent ATVs. We do all that fun stuff out here. So I have a contract with everything in Vegas. We shoot guns, we do ATVs and bullets and burgers and all kinds of different stuff. So whatever you guys need, we can make it happen. Generally, we can even get you a little bit more than you could if you booked on your own, because we have a long-standing relationship with a lot of these places, and we do bring a ton of business. So definitely let us, you know, take the opportunity to try to, you know, do your whole vacation. You know, if you can do it better on your own, great. If you don't want the hassles and you want us to do it and more than likely get a better deal with us, we'll go ahead and do it for you guys. So That's it for the video. Hopefully you guys got a lot of knowledge today. I wanted to, you know, I felt like there was a void on the internet here on YouTube and whatnot of, you know, people talking about bottle service. This is 2018, and maybe some of the percentages and whatnot might change going forward. So if you're seeing this video, you know, a year or two down the road, it's possible that some of these, you know, percentages have changed a little bit, or the nightclubs have changed. You know, there's always changes. It's, you know, never going to be perfect time to do the video, but right now is the time. We're talking fall of 2018, and if there's a lot of changes, I'll go ahead and redo it at some point and, you know, add new venues and percentages and whatnot in for you guys. But I'm Brian Pfeiffer, owner of SurrealNightlife.com. Hope you enjoyed today. We'll talk to you guys later.